In this video, I'm going to show you how to find a good campsite. Now, these guidelines hold true whether you're trying to find a backpacking campsite or a car camping campsite. But primarily, this is going to be about how to find a good backpacking campsite. But if you don't backpack, you still should watch this video because, like I said, the guidelines hold true even if you're just going to go car camping. So if you're new to backpacking or camping, or you've never even tried it before because you don't know how to do it, well, then in this video, I'm going to tell you what you need to help you get started. And later in this video, I'm even going to give you an acronym that's going to help you remember what to look for when you're trying to find a campsite. So let's get started. All right, but first of all, what does it mean to choose a campsite or find a campsite? Well, finding a campsite really just means where are you going to set up your tent? So the first step really could be use a map. Yeah, an old-fashioned paper map. Try to locate an area that looks suitable to you. Find an area that you want to go to. But one of the things that you want to identify as you're looking for a place, whether it's on a map or on some digital app, is you want to make sure that you can actually camp there. Is camping allowed where you're going to go? Now, remember I said that I'm going to give you an acronym to help you remember what to look for in a good camp spot. And so as you're evaluating the different spots, one of the things that you want to first look for, is there an open space that's big enough to accommodate your tent, basically your tent footprint? And if you've got a tent that has guy lines on it, you want to make sure that there's enough room so that you can guy out your tent. And before we start talking about the spots that would represent good campsites, let's talk about the spots that would represent bad campsites. These are spots that you don't want to set up your tent in. Number one, don't set up your tent too close to the trail. First of all, you probably aren't going to want people walking through your camp or walking next to your camp because you're going to want some solitude. But then the other thing to consider is that other people may not want to really see other people when they're on their trip. So if they have to walk right past your camp, that could ruin their experience for them. Number two, don't set up your tent on ground that has too much of a slope. Now, I personally like a little bit of slope to set up my tent on. It just helps me sleep better. But if the ground has too much of a slope and you're trying to sleep, then either you're going to slide down to the bottom of your tent during the night, or if you're trying to sleep the other way, then you're going to slide this way and your head's going to be crammed into the front of the tent and all the blood's going to go to your head and it's not going to be a comfortable experience. Number three, this one should be pretty obvious, but don't set up your tent in an area that's full of rocks or other snags. You may not be able to get the tent stakes into the ground because of all the rocks. And then with all those rocks or even just lumpy ground, that's not going to be very comfortable to try to sleep on. Number four, now you can set up your tent underneath a tree canopy, but try to avoid setting up your tent in an area that's got a bunch of dead branches above you. What you don't want to have happen is a heavy wind comes along and knocks some of those branches off and those fall on your tent. What could be even worse is if you set up in an area where there are dead trees, again, if a heavy wind comes along, then that dead tree could fall over and land on your tent. And that might be the end of you. So don't do that. Number four, don't set up your tent in what I call the lowlands. And so that's really any valley or any spot that's low. So if you've got two hills or two mountains and comes down into a valley like that, that's where cold air is going to collect during the night and especially in the morning. And if you're setting up your tent there, you're going to freeze, I guarantee it. And number six is similar. Don't set up your tent somewhere close to water. Number one, usually water is in a low spot. It's either in a canyon, or it's in a valley, or it's in a meadow. So the cold air is going to collect there just because of the downslope of air, but cold air is going to follow that path of water during the night, and that's going to make it a really cold night for you. And so if you set up your tent by water, then in the morning, moist air could condense inside your tent, making you and everything inside your tent wet. No fun. And number seven, try to find an established campsite. So this would be a spot where it's obvious that tents have been set up. Maybe there's even a fire ring already established. Those are the best places to set up a camp rather than trying to just trailblaze and make your own campsite. Number eight, you want to avoid areas that are lightning magnets. You want to avoid high open hilltops or hillsides, even meadows. And maybe it'd be a good idea not to set up your tent close to the tallest tree around. Remember, you're in a tent that has metal stakes driven into the ground, and lightning can actually travel through the ground if it strikes, so you want to be as far away from where you think lightning will strike as possible. Lastly, if you do find a spot that looks good to you, consider what's around in the environment. What tripping hazards are there that you might discover during the middle of the night when you're doing your midnight business? What kind of low overhanging branches are there that you might hit your head on during the middle of the night, or even during the day when you're just walking around your tent? Are there any animal tracks or scat close to your campsite, which could indicate that that's a travel path for those animals? Or lastly, is there anything like poison ivy or poison oak close to your campsite? All right, I promised you that I was going to give you an acronym to help you remember what to look for in a good campsite as you're out in the woods. Now, I fully admit that this is not a great acronym word for especially backpacking, and it's wheels. Yes, wheels. So let's work through what the different letters of the wheels acronym stands for. Oh, and by the way, if you can come up with a better acronym, I would really appreciate that. Leave it in the comments section down below, and maybe I'll adopt that and put it into another video. And I would appreciate it if you could come up with something better than wheels. But for now, this is what I've got. So let's work through the different letters of our wheels acronym. First is W. W stands for water. Now, I told you, don't set up your tent right next to water, but if you're on a backpacking trip, you've got to have access to water. So you want to be close enough to water that it's easily accessible to you so that you can get water for filtering and then for drinking or cooking, but not so close to the water that you're going to be experiencing all the moisture problems, all the bug problems that come with it, and the cold problems. So make sure that you've got a good water source, a clean water source that's close enough to you that you can easily get to it whenever you need water at camp. All right, the next letter in our acronym is H, and that stands for high. You want to be on ground that's higher up. You don't want to be in the lowlands, like I said. Remember, warm air rises, cold air sinks. So if you're up high, then that area in the night and in the morning is actually going to be warmer than it is down low, where your favorite spot might be next to the creek. So the next letter in our acronym is E. Well, what does this E stand for? Well, this stands for exposure. Well, what do I mean by that? Well, I like to set up a tent somewhere where I'm going to get exposure to morning light. And that just helps cut through that chill from the evening and early morning. So the next E in our acronym is for established campsites. I really think that this is probably the best practice. Certainly, if you're just starting out, it's going to be the easiest thing for you to find. Just look for an established campsite, but then just make sure that it meets the criteria of everything that I've told you, all the negative things, plus all these positive things in our acronym WHEELS. I still really want a better acronym. Somebody help me. The next letter in the acronym is L, and that stands for level. Now remember, I said that I actually like just a little bit of slope. So maybe the L could stand for little bit of slope. There we go. I like that better. But just make sure that the ground that you're setting your tent up on doesn't have too much of a slope that's going to cause you to slide and slip around inside your tent. Or if you're going the other way, that it's going to cause an uncomfortable night of sleep from all the blood rushing to your head. And the last letter in our acronym is S, and that stands for sheltered, or it could stand for screened. And what I mean by that is just somewhere that's going to act as a windbreak. So you can see I've got trees behind me, and I've set my tent up on the leeward side of these trees. So that way the wind coming through there is going to get broken up by the trees, and it's not going to affect my tent so much. So you know what you need to do now, right? Watch this video right here, or check out this playlist right here. They're awesome. Trust me.